I want to tell you how I got my job teaching at Anderson School of Theology in 1990. I was teaching at Azusa Pacific for a year. We had just come back from Scotland, and the year was winding down and wasn't sure if I was going to stay at Azusa for another year or move on. But Dr. James Earl Massey, who was the dean of Anderson School of Theology at that time, was out in California for a board meeting at World Vision in Pasadena. So at Paula's recommendation, I called him up and found out he was going to be out here, and he invited me to meet him for dinner. So I went out to Pasadena from Azusa, and we had a nice dinner, good conversation. And then as we were walking out, we talked and we shook hands, and I walked out to my car, and I remember he was standing there at the entrance watching me go, just watching me. It's kind of an eerie feeling as he was watching me walk to my car. Later on, I realized what he was doing. He was asking the Holy Spirit if he should make me an offer for a faculty position at the School of Theology. He was listening to what the Spirit would say to him. He would say later, he always acted by perceived guidance. He was listening to the Spirit. You know, in Luke chapter 11 and verse 13, Jesus said that you ask the Father, and the Father will give you the Holy Spirit, will give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him. But I think one of the things we sometimes forget is if we're going to have the Holy Spirit in our midst, the church has to operate by listening to the Spirit. And there's a difference between listening to what other churches are doing. There's a difference between listening to the Spirit and thinking this is what we've done in the past. And there's a difference between listening to the Spirit and operating by whim. It seems to me the closer to the Lord that we grow, by the more we learn to listen to the Spirit, the stronger we will have the presence and power of the Lord in our midst. Sometimes there's times to just be quiet and learn to listen. Let the Holy Spirit make the choices and then follow the choices as he leads. Great verse in Acts chapter 11 when Peter's explaining why he went to Cornelius' house. He says this in verse 12, "The Spirit told me to go." When we listen to the Spirit will tell us when to go, when to stay, and when to wait. This is your daily devotional for Tuesday. I hope you're doing well. Hope you're looking forward to our great day of prayer coming up on Saturday. Seek the kingdom of God and pray for the church and pray for me. Read your Bible today and look forward to seeing you soon. God bless you as you serve him.